Hello, I'm Evan Brand, functional medicine practitioner and nutritional therapist, talking with you today about cortisol, inverse cortisol rhythms, inverse cortisol patterns. Cortisol is a stress hormone. It gets a bad rap. Everybody talks about cortisol. It's like, oh God, my cortisol is through the roof. Oh, I gotta have cortisol problems. I'm so fatigued. My adrenals, I have adrenal fatigue. There's a lot of discussion about it, but not really concrete discussion. And so what I see when I review thousands and thousands of lab results of adrenal testing and my clients, this is your normal cortisol rhythm. This is a stress hormone that's supposed to be highest within the first hour. You want to be somewhere between here and here in the first hour of waking. So this is like charging your iPhone. People love that analogy. You want your battery fully charged in the day, right? And you're going to gradually drain that battery throughout the whole day. But imagine if you wake up and your iPhone's at 7%. People freak out, as opposed to if their energy, their own personal body vehicle, is at 7%. People just drink coffee and just pound away the sugar and pound away the carbohydrates and just push on. And it's just insane. Now, if we use the iPhone analogy, people care and they're more empathetic. It's surprising. You should worry about your energy levels more than your phone's energy. So most people, you know, what we'll see a lot of times, this is the low end of optimal, this is the high end of optimal. You know, I'll see people that they don't even peak at all, and then they just drag. Maybe they do coffee and they get bumped up into an optimal rhythm and then they just crash out. So this is the person that has to have coffee to feel good, or I have to work out to feel good or feel normal. That's what you're doing. You're artificially cranking up cortisol to bump it into rhythm so that you feel okay to get through the day. Now, what I've often seen is this inverse cortisol pattern, which is where people can start out, maybe let's just say this person's okay in the morning. They maybe have a little peak, and they crash out by noon, they're exhausted, ready to close up shop. But then when they lay down at night, they're wired and tired and they can't sleep and they're restless, they're tossing and turning, they have insomnia, they're up scrolling on Instagram till 2 a.m. Bad, bad, bad habits. The blue light in your eyes is not only cranking up cortisol, but it's contributing to this inverse cortisol pattern. Now, there's other causes. This could be related to the gut. This could be related to parasite infections, bacterial overgrowth problems that stimulate these nerves in the stomach. People tend to have the inverse pattern when I see infections. I can't say that it directly causes it, parasites cause this or bacteria causes this, but I've just seen the correlation hundreds of times that when people do have infections, all of a sudden cortisol goes up at night. And then we can bring this back down into rhythm. Let's just draw our chart. If we're somewhere in here, they're okay. But if they're out of rhythm, not only is that going to cause you to be restless, but also you're increasing your risk of diseases, because melatonin, as you know, it's a famous sleep hormone, but melatonin is also a potent antioxidant, and it's one of the most potent antioxidants that our body produces. So when we're talking about cancer prevention or successfully eradicating cancer, you've got to have adequate levels of melatonin. You cannot have high cortisol and high melatonin. It's one or the other. It's a seesaw. So if cortisol is high, melatonin's low. If melatonin's high, cortisol must be low. You have to have that straightened out. How can you fix this? Well, a couple different ways. You know, phosphatidylserine, that's a good fatty acid that I've used successfully to bring inverse patterns down. Adaptogenic herbs can be great to normalize this cortisol rhythm. You gotta work with a practitioner on this, because if you go and you just take something like licorice, you could crank this level up and make yourself feel worse, have anxiety, panic, insomnia, even worse problems. You don't wanna do that. You gotta stabilize blood sugar. So that's why I wrote about ketogenic diets. I follow a cyclical ketogenic diet where I'm following keto a few days a week, and then a few days I'm adding in starches and I'm breaking that ketogenic cycle. That's what I push most of my clients towards, and most people do very, very well with that, because that's what our ancestors did for hundreds of thousands of years before it was a trendy buzzword. Exercise, the right amount, not too much. The right dose of exercise can help calibrate this rhythm, especially in the morning. If you do a nice little 7-minute workout in the morning, you can optimize that. Light therapy. So remember, cortisol is a light-driven hormone. If you've got your blinds closed and you're hiding in the dark staring at a little screen, do you think you're going to have optimal cortisol? No. Open the windows. Open the blinds. Get bright light. Stop wearing sunglasses. If you wear them, maybe you're skiing or sledding, or there's a really bright area and you have to just have them because of the glare. Sure. But if you're somebody who throws on those sunglasses before you even walk outside, it's likely you've got a cortisol slash adrenal problem. So I'd refer you to my adrenal videos. You have to have light to bump up cortisol, and you don't want light at night. You want to live like a pioneer. You want nothing but a candle on or a salt lamp at night. Float tanks. Those are great. They can help modulate cortisol. It's called rest therapy in the literature. It can be really great at modifying cortisol rhythm and dropping cortisol into a normal pattern. Massage. Anything that's going to engage that parasympathetic mode, that rest and digest mode that a lot of us are deficient in. We're go, go, go all the time. Massage, float tanks, essential oils, light therapy, taking a vacation, going to the beach, swimming, meditation, just getting to bed on time, getting off your phone, getting off Facebook. These are all the strategies you can implement to fix this inverse cortisol pattern. How do you know if you have an inverse pattern? Well, you can go based on symptoms, but the best way is to test, not guess. Get this 6-point cortisol panel done with a saliva test using a functional medicine practitioner, and then you can investigate, figure out what's going on, measure it, get it on a piece of paper before you start buying a bunch of supplements you think that are good for you. They might not be. You got to get that stuff tested, figure it out, be accurate, be diligent, and you can fix this. This is Evan Brand signing out. If you'd like help, click on screen. Be happy to help. Take care. Bye-bye.